I shot this video a couple of weeks ago after I had a good weekend's haul of wall clocks. I scored four of them, three of them weight driven in pretty good condition, and a fourth one spring driven that's going to need a fair bit of repair and restoration done to it. These are the clocks that I purchased. Hello everybody, I'm Scotty from Scotty's Clock World. Thanks for joining me back on my channel. I had a good haul of vintage wall clocks last weekend. One Black Forest Cuckoo clock, two Dutch clocks. This is the first one we'll have a look at. The Cuckoo clock. Obviously the hands aren't original. They'll be changed and I'll put a proper set on it. I've got no idea where they came from. That's the pendulum. The top is in good shape. It's even got a little glass eye in the bird. Two weights, 1750 grams each. They're original. As you can see, there's no numbers written on them. The modern ones from the 60s and 70s onwards have the weight cast into them. These don't. It's a Black Forest Cuckoo clock. Five leaf, one, two, three. Two on the top up. Five leaf and one bird. It's an 8 day movement. 32 centimeters tall, 21 wide and 12 deep. It's an old clock. If we turn it over, see if you can see it there. The count wheel has got pins on it. It doesn't have slots in it. So it's quite an old movement. I don't know what brand it is, but we'll check that once we take it to pieces and find out more about it. Both bellow tops are damaged, as you can see in there. There's one of them falling out and they need to be replaced. So we'll put Tyvek paper on those and we'll get the whole movement up and running again. As I said, it's an 8 day movement. So that'll look rather nice when it's hanging on the wall. Our next clock is a Dutch clock. Zaansee Zaandam Atlas clock. Pretty dusty, it's been in the shop for a while where we bought it from. Has an 8 day movement. Pendulum is a man riding a horse. That's an original pendulum for it. And the original weights. ...840 grams each. The size of the clock is 50 centimeters tall, 20 centimeters wide and 12 centimeters deep. You can see it's the original hands and the Atlas up the top. That's the cup bell that the clock strikes on under Atlas. We'll clean that up when we get to it. The hammer lever is misaligned and it's hitting the bell and staying on it, so there's no resonance. It just sort of goes clunk, but we'll sort that out when we get there. Our next clock is a Sallander wall clock, a Dutch wall clock. An 8 day movement, chains on it, made by Warmink, so you know it's a good quality movement. Turn that round. It's a moon phase. You can see that up there. The pendulum is missing, but it's in the shape of a stylized sun. The weights are missing also. They're pretty heavy weights. They're 1700 grams each. The overall height of the clock is 50 centimeters. It's 23 centimeters wide and 15 centimeters deep. It strikes the hours and the half hours on a cup bell, which is down inside here. The last of our four clocks is a Japanese wall clock, Tokyo Mark brand. It's a 10 inch drop octagonal strike clock. I'll lift it up so you can see the dial. Here we go. And down on the bottom where the pendulum is, it's upside down at the moment. We'll spin that round. It's got a hand painting of the face of a young girl. Interestingly enough, it has a Waterbury Clock Company movement inside it. The case works pretty rough. You can see there's lacquers chipped off around the place. It's separating in a few places around here. So the case work will be taken to pieces completely, stripped down, cleaned, restained, and then rebuilt, put back together again, and then it'll be polished to have a satin shine on it. We don't want it to be very shiny because wood is not shiny. Satin will look pretty good on that. Little bit of marking on the paper dial, but there's nothing we can do about that in actual fact. Anyway, that's our fourth clock. It was a good weekend for wall clocks, four of them. So plenty of work there to do. So I've got an idea of another set of clocks that we'll be working on over the next month or two.